guys enjoyed this lookbook. This was my take on cottagecore. Cottagecore, I'm sure if you guys have been on the internet, has been a recent trend emerging that just celebrates all things nature, field, cozy, cottage, country, anything other than the current world. And speaking of the current world, there's a reason for this whole lookbook, I guess. All of our borders have been closed down since the pandemic started, and I haven't been able to actually visit my family in the province that I'm from. I've only lived in this house and this province for 2 years, so I've been really, 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 really missing my family and my home. And then they announced on July 3rd that they were opening a thing called an Atlantic bubble, which allows for people within these Atlantic provinces to travel to and from. So basically, this lookbook has been a big celebratory, oh my god, I was allowed home again, frolicking around Prince Edward Island, I got to see my mom! And also just cottagecore funness. I do want to say, I'm probably gonna get comments saying this isn't true cottagecore, or that it's closer to fairycore. I hope you will accept this as my attempt. You will probably know that my aesthetic is very technicolor in the first place. I tried to Google fairycore and I tried to research that a bit, but like, y'all, cottagecore is definitely the one that is like getting the hashtags and the clicks, so please, please bear with me if this isn't like as nature toned as you would like. I want to do just a little cheeky chat through each of the looks too. I didn't want to talk over the lookbook because I really liked the song that I picked. But yeah, the first look, I wore my Miss Candy Holic dress. I love this so much. This originally came with 3 strawberry patches on it, but unfortunately they came off in the wash and I need to restick them. But I wore this cute little gingham dress with a yellow, I believe, secondhand, amazing little embroidered floral apron that my friend Alice mailed to me as like a little secret surprise prezzy. Oh my god, thank you so much, Alice. Yeah, I like immediately put it on and was like, this is a look, this is in rotation now. I love this. And the hat I've had for like years. I did end up wearing pretty much the same shoes for every look, and the accessories slash hat wear isn't as diverse as it could be. Again, because I was like on vacation, kind of living out of a suitcase, so that's why the shoes and socks aren't as a dressing. The second look again is some thrifted action along with some lingerie elements, ooh ooh. I had this little lavender purpley pinky button down top that I thrifted, I believe this year or late last year, one of my last satisfying thrift finds. And I just threw this little baby doll over top. I got this lingerie pink baby doll thing from La Vie en Rose, again, like 4 years ago. And yeah, it's just a good staple that goes with lots of stuff. The third look, this was actually the first one that I filmed, but I put it here because it's probably the least cottagecore. But I kind of packed and I put things together. You'll notice that I packed a lot of like florally embroidered thrifted action, as well as a lot of lingerie, lacy, kind of, ooh, vintage lace elements. So this was kind of, I was working off of that, but it turned into like, maybe cottagecore if you were a grandma in the 70s? Like, very 70s. A grandma cottage, I don't know, but I thought it was fun. We wore this out. This is the only look that we shot in like a public setting. We went to a little country market flower place called Jules, so that's why I was wearing a mask. And the final look, this is another secondhand floral, ooh, floral secondhand notes. I actually picked up this dress at a little like sell your clothes swap and shop market before an indie show on PEI. I miss when my life was cooler. But I picked up this dress for $10! Why did they give it to me for $10? I don't know, but I love this dress so much. It is just big and baggy. The one thing I don't like is the cut of the top. It's very like pumpkin time, but it's just that embroidery and it's everywhere. I love it so much. And I paired this with another thrifted peignoir over toppy floaty see-through lingerie moment. Oh yeah, and I tied just a little pink ribbon belt thing around the waist to kind of tie in those pink notes. I keep saying notes like each look is a candle. It was really, really lovely and refreshing to be able to see my family again and to just to be able to access my home entirely. Prince Edward Island is an island and it is attached to the rest of Canada via the Confederation Bridge, and that bridge has been like womp womp, can't come since the pandemic started. And I was definitely starting to maybe lose my nugget a little bit, starting to go a bit wacky in the four walls, feeling like literally thinking that I made up and materialized and like just made up all of my childhood memories and that none of those places really existed. They exist. Being back home after it was a 9 or 10 day trip, I feel so much better. I have all this fun fashion content for you. I love filming and taking pics with my mama. I missed my mama so much. I have lots of fun little bloopers and outtakes and stuff I'm gonna put at the end too, because I love my mom. And yeah, I hope you guys like this little fashion lookbook. Cottagecore, Jill goes back to PEI, mom. Celebration. This video's Peach Confetti Club member is PuriNyx on Instagram, who did this absolutely incredible artwork. Oh my gosh, and there's a little speed draw. Ooh, okay, I probably can't put the video in here, but I love this so much. The little texture on the shirt and the fanny pack and the dynamic pose. This is beautiful. Oh my gosh. I wish I could just art like that. Thank you so much for this. I appreciate it very much. I love you guys so much. And yeah, stay tuned for cute little bloops if you'd like. Ooh, dress time. It's dress time with the dress and the fume. Oh, my fabrics are so thin. Socks and sandals, who? It's okay. It's cute. Oh. Maybe some, like, I don't know, dapple wipe action.
Double light action. Beep 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 beep. Why am I humming like a bear went into the woods one day?
Because I'm a bear.
You're like a little Goldilocks. You're like a pixie lock. Oh shit. Okay, go do that again.
We're not recording that whole time.
Just that last bit.
Starting where?
Just go run around and be cute. You remind me of Amelia. You know? Amelia fart when she runs around.
Is my bow cute?
Your bow's super cute. And your butt's super cute. The dappled light is dappling on your butt cheeks.
Beautiful. Just beautiful.
And when the hat makes you look like you're a pirate. Are you going for Rainbow Pirate? Ooh, the wind, give me the motion of the skirtage. Ooh. 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 Look at this.
My dainty little biscuit. Ooh, would you like anything from my dainty little biscuit?
I believe it looks like you have eaten them all.
Oh shit, yeah, you're right.
I'm going around the pixie locks. Going around the pixie locks. Ring around the pixie locks.